So good morning. Today we will discuss new topic, Kirchhoff's laws. This is basic laws as far as current electricity is concerned. You must have learned Coulomb's law in electrostatics, where you use that law in order to derive many other new concepts and physical quantities. So we will be using Kirchhoff's laws in current electricity in order to derive many other equations. So this is very fundamental. Now let us see what those laws are. There are two laws. In Kirchhoff's laws, there are two laws, which are the current law and also the voltage law. So here you can see the two laws. Current law states that the current flowing into a node or a junction is equal to the current flowing out of it. This is the consequence of charge conservation. As you can see here, the total current entering the junction, I1, I2 and I3, they are entering the junction, should be equal to the total current leaving the junction, that is I4 plus I5.
Teacher?
Yes.
Teacher, the blue color one is the circuit.
This blue color?
Yeah, yeah.
The blue circle. Color represents the current coming into the circuit, into the junction. Okay? That color changes okay. Only to...
Teacher, he's saying about the circle one, blue circle.
Teacher. Is just to focus on the node or the junction. There is nothing there.
There is two laws, right?
What?
There is two laws. Okay, so see, the right one indicates there is the only the value of I will be 0.2 ampere. Only the current will be constant, right?
This figure is in order to explain the voltage law. Now we are explaining the current law. So you have to focus only on this figure. These two are separate figures. Okay?
Means the two separate figures represent the two laws, right?
Yeah. This okay. Figure represents the first law and this figure okay. Represents the second law. So when we talk about the current law or the first law, it states that the total current entering the junction should be equal to the current leaving the junction. So if I1, I2, I3 are 2 ampere, 3 ampere and 4 ampere, it will add up to 9 ampere. So the total current coming out also should be 9 ampere. Suppose I5 is 8 ampere, what will be I4?
One
ampere. So that is first law or the current law. Now let us go to the second law, which is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Kirchhoff's voltage law states that the sum of all voltages around any closed loop in a circuit must equal zero. So here you can see this is a closed loop. There is one source of voltage which is providing 12 volt and a current 0.2 ampere is flowing throughout this loop. So we can consider 0.2 ampere as the current flowing through resistance R1, R2 and R3. Okay, so here what will be the voltage loss? You can tell it as current times resistance. I into R1 is 2. 0.2 times 10 is 2 volt. Again here, what will be the current? 0.2 ampere itself. So 0.2 times 20, you will get 4 volt. So the voltage dropped across this resistance is 4 volt. Again, the voltage dropped across this resistance is 0.2 times 30, which will be 6 volt. So the total voltage drop is 2 plus 4 plus 6, which will be equal to 12 volt. So let me just stop the screen sharing and show on the whiteboard how to write equations for circuit using Kirchhoff's voltage law. So
yes, for that,
let me just show you the...
Teacher, your internet is too slow.
My internet is slow.
Yeah, it's too blur.
Okay, later when we record, maybe it will be clear to you. Can you see the whiteboard now?
Yeah, we can see.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so Kirchhoff's voltage law. So KVL sometimes means Kirchhoff's voltage law. In order to show how to get into equations using this law, let me consider a circuit. Okay, there is a circuit like this. Okay, so here, let me again put a resistance here. Suppose this is R1, this is R2, this is R3, this is R4, this is R5. I'm not putting any resistance here. Okay, and suppose this voltage is V1. And this voltage is V2. Okay, so they are providing these EMF. And suppose a current flows from here, I1. Current starts from here. When it comes here, this current may split into two. Let me take the current across R2 as I2 and the current through R3 as I3. Okay, and after coming here, let me take the current coming through I4 as I4, and this is through R4. So let me consider it as R5. This is R5, right? So let me just put it as R5. This is roughly any circuit. I just want to show you how we can use Kirchhoff's voltage law in order to write an equation. First point is we have to consider a loop. So just to name the loop, I'm putting here points A, B, C, D, E, F. Just to name the loop and just putting some points like this. Okay? So let us take the loop and considering a loop A, B, E, F, A. A, B, E, F, A. This will show you how the loop is going. So I am going to take this circle alone. Now I will apply Kirchhoff's law here. So I am starting from here. I1 is going in the direction in which I am taking the loop. So in my direction. So I will take it as I1 R1 plus. See, I3 is going also in the same direction in which I am considering the loop. So I3 R3 plus I3 R3. Okay. And I4 is also going in the same direction I am considering the loop. So I4 R4. So plus I4 R4. Now when I come to this point, I see the negative first. This is negative, this is positive, right? So when I see the negative first, I am writing minus E1 is equal to 0. This is how I can write an equation for this loop A, B, E, F, A.
Teacher, can I explain again?
Yes.
Can you explain again the equation part?
Yeah, I will explain again. One more thing. Let me just. Like, first we have to take a loop and go along the loop with current and resistance. So, first when I go here, I1 R1. The same direction I3 R3. So plus I3 R3. In this direction I4 R4. So plus I4 R4. And then I saw the negative first. So minus E1 is equal to 0. This is the first equation I got. Or I can write it as I1 R1 plus I3 R3 plus I4 R4. Is equal to E1. Minus E1, when I took to other side, it becomes E1. Now, I would like you to tell me how the equation will go if I take the second loop, this loop. Okay, so how I am going, can you name the loop now starting from B?
B, C, D, E, B.
Yes, correct. B, C, D, E, B. So you know how to go, right? Okay, now Haseena, can you tell me the equation?
I2R2 plus R3.
We reach C. Are we seeing R3 now? No.
No.
So you are seeing the cell here, right?
Plus E2.
So you are seeing this cell. So you have to tell plus E2 because you found plus first, right?
So yes.
Plus E2. Okay, then?
Plus I5 R5.
Yeah, plus I5 R5.
Plus.
Unfortunately, okay, now we haven't completed. After that, tell me.
Plus I3 R3.
Will it be plus or minus? It will be minus because we are traveling in this direction, but the current is coming opposite to us. In all these cases, current was going in the same direction as our loop went. I2R2 and positive, so plus, then I5R5, because current is going in our same direction. Now current is going in the opposite direction from us. So I'll put here minus I3R3. Is that clear? If the current is in the same direction as the loop goes, you can take it as I2R2, I5R5. Now I3 is in the opposite direction. So I'll put it as minus I3R3 is equal to 0. Okay?
Yes, teacher.
Now let me consider one more loop. Can Muhammad Jaman tell me the loop? I'm taking the outer loop from here, all like this. Just to give a practice of writing equations using Kirchhoff's voltage law. So how will you name the loop?
So I will start saying I1 R1 plus.
Yeah, first let us name the loop.
Okay, A, B, C, D, E, F, A.
Yes, the big loop. Okay, so can you tell the equation starting from A, right? Yeah.
Okay, I1 R1.
Yes.
Plus I2 R2.
Yes.
Plus E2.
Yes.
Plus R5, I5?
Yes.
Plus R4, I4?
I4, R4.
Minus I1.
Minus E1.
Minus E1.
Is equal yes. to 0. So you got an idea how to use Kirchhoff's voltage law.
I3 and R3. What happened with the I3 and R3?
This doesn't come on the way. Only if it comes in the way, we have to include that. We are traveling from A to B, B to C, D to E, E to F, then A, right? I3, R3 didn't come in our way. You have to include that only if it comes in the way.
Okay.
Is it clear to you how to write an equation?
Yes.
Okay, now let us further see how to solve some problems using both of these equations. Yes?
Teacher, you wrote loop B, C, D, E, B, right?
Loop
B, C, D, E, and B. Yeah, this one, see, if I2, R2 plus E2, then after there will be minus, right? After E2. Because the circuit and CC. You see the circuit?
Yeah, I see the circuit here.
So can I see the just
oh, yeah,
turn
yeah,
the
I'm
camera?
Sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. So here.
See, yeah, I two R two plus yes. E two, and yes. then after E two it comes minus. See, the negative sign is there.
Why minus? I five is in this direction.
But before there is a minus sign, right? We are coming from C to D.
Yeah, here you use the logic that the current should be from positive cell to this. So I phi should be in this direction. Was that your idea?
No.
This minus and plus, I just showed to show that this terminal is negative, this terminal is positive.
Okay.
Then current I just mentioned in this direction.
But teacher, why minus I3 and R3?
Because I'm going in this direction in the loop, but current I3 is coming in opposite direction, not in the way I'm going.
Yeah. Okay, teacher, understood.
Not in the way I'm going. So, like that, if you are solving a problem and if you find the value as a negative quantity of current, then what you have to do is you have to take the direction of current you assume that will be opposite to that. Okay, well, you can, when you assume, you can put any direction and write the equation following this law. And when you solve a problem, if it turns out to be a negative value for current, that means what you assumed is wrong. It's in the opposite direction. That's all. Let us see the problems. Then you can get a better view. Okay. So we were here, right? Okay. Now let me again go to the PowerPoint, and then okay, let us see some problems. Okay, let us see some problem. Okay, can you see the problem here?
Yes, teacher.
Hello? Yeah. This is a problem which I took from your textbook. A cell of EMF 2 volt and internal resistance 2 ohm is in parallel connection with two resistors with resistances of 5 ohm and 10 ohm. Apply Kirchhoff's law, find the amount of electric current that is sent by the cell and find the electric current in each resistors. So here is the circuit. There is a cell providing 2 volt. It has an internal resistance 2 ohm. So remember, when they have given an internal resistance, a current I is passing through this, right? So in addition to 2 volt, you have to consider I into 2, IR, I into small r. Okay? If you are using this loop at all. And then there are two resistors, 5 ohm and 10 ohm, which are connected in parallel. So a total current I coming at this junction A will split into I1 and I2. Now we have to find out the electric current that is sent by the cell. So what is I? And find the electric current in each resistors. So we have to find I1 and I2 as well. So first of all, what they have done, they have applied Kirchhoff's first law at point A. Do you remember what is Kirchhoff's first law? Can anyone of you tell me? Kirchhoff's first law.
The amount of current enters into a node.
Entering the node is?
The amount of current enters in a node will be
equal to the amount of
current
equal to
leaving the node. Yeah. So what is the current entering? I yes. is equal to I1 plus I2. I1 and I2 are leaving the node, right? I is entering. So they wrote the first equation, I is equal to I1 plus I2. Now Kirchhoff's second law or voltage law in the closed circuit, EAR1BE, that is E. They use this as a letter. So E A R1 B E. So we have to go like this. Okay. So starting from here, they have go on and they have write I into 2. I into 2 because I is the current flowing through this line and 2 is the internal resistance here. So they have mentioned I into 2. Then they went through A, they saw this. So I1 is passing through R1. So I1 into 5. That is why they have mentioned I into 2 plus I1 into 5. Then they came, there is nothing here, nothing here. Minus E is equal to 0. Or they have written equal to 2 volt. This can be either written as minus 2 volt is equal to 0. Or you can write it as I into 2 plus I1 5 is equal to 2 volt. Is this equation clear to you?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay. Teacher.
Then what they did was instead of I, the total current you have from equation 1, I1 plus I2. So they substitute instead of I1 plus I2 and they got this equation. Then they took 2I1 plus 2I2 plus 5I1 is equal to 2 volt. So 2I1 plus 5I1 is 7I1 plus 2I2 is equal to 2 volt. So they got the second equation. And now they are applying.
Teacher, can you explain that again?
Which one?
After I1 multiplied by R1. Second law.
This I1 multiplied by R1.
Teacher, can you explain that? Can you write in the board and explain?
Yeah. Okay. So I will solve that on the board maybe. Oh, I forgot to take that. You can tell me this. Can you see the board?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, teacher, but it's
blue. Board now? Yeah. Okay. I need to write down the, draw the circuit. Help me with the values, okay? When I draw the circuit, please help me with the values. So there was a cell here. I remember this is positive, negative, 2 volt, right? E is equal to 2 volt and it has an internal resistance 2 ohm. And here there was one resistance. Is there a resistance here? No. It's connected to two parallel resistances, right? Like this, right? What is R1?
Yes, teacher.
5
ohm. And what is R2?
10.
10 ohm. Okay. This is all, right? So a current I is flowing through the circuit. It gets split up here as I2 and I3. So this is the question. And you have to find I2 and I3, right? And they have labeled this point as A and this point as B. That's it, right? And first, they use the current law to find I is equal to I1 plus I2, right? They have used it as I1 and I2. So I1 plus I2. This they got by applying current law to the junction A. Now they are taking the loop from here to here, which means they have taken the loop E, A, R1, B, E. So starting from here. So I current is going through an internal resistance 2 ohm. So we can make it as I into 2. Then comes I1 R1. R1 is 5. So plus I1 into 5. Then they came all the way here minus. So minus 2 is equal to 0. Or they mentioned it as 2i plus 5i1 is equal to 2. I took minus 2 to the other side. Is this clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. This one they took. Then they substituted instead of I1 plus I2. So what they did? 2 times I1 plus I2 is plus 5I1 is equal to 2. So they took 2 inside. So 2I1 plus 2I2 plus 5I1 is equal to 2. Or 2I1 plus 5I1, you will get it as 7I1 plus 2I2 is equal to 2. This is equation 1. Now is it clear to you?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Someone is waiting. Let me just let her in. Okay. Now, next what they have done is, they have applied this equation to the other loop here. The loop, because we need to include R2 as well, right? So they have taken a loop like this down. So they have taken a loop like E, A, R2, B, E. The difference is earlier it was going through R1, now it is going to R2. So the equation like this will become starting from here. So 2 into I plus 2 into I internal resistance into I plus I2 R2. R2 is 10. So 10I2. I'm writing this as 10I2. Okay. Then it comes and this is negative. So minus 2 is equal to 0. Or you can write it as equal to 2. Minus 2 equal to 0 is same as writing as equal to 2. Is this clear?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Then what they did is, they again substituted for I, I1 plus I2. So this equation will become what? 2 times I1 plus I2 plus 10I2 will be equal to 2. So taking this inside, 2I1 plus 2I2 plus 10I2 is equal to 2. So 2I1, 10 plus 2, 12. 12I2 is equal to 2. So they got here, we have all 2. So I can cancel throughout 2, right? So I will get the same equation as I1 plus 6I2 is equal to 1. So this is equation number 2. Now you have got 2 equations here, right? Yes. So can we solve this equation? Yeah, where is this equation? 7i1 plus 2i2 is equal to 2. And I1 plus 6i2 is equal to 1. So in order to make the quotient for I1 same, let me multiply this equation 2 with 7. We are solving equation 1 and 2 in order to find I1 and I2. So if I multiply this equation with 7, this will become 7i1 plus 6 sevens are?
42.
6 sevens are?
42.
42 i2 is equal to 7. So I got this as equation number 3. Now I may not need this. So let me rub this part.
Yes.
So the figure I'm rubbing.
The rest is easy, right? We'll just subtract, right? 3 minus 1.
3 minus?
Means the equation 3 minus equation 1. This one we will do, right?
You can use equation 3 minus equation 1. So 7i1 minus 7i1 gone. 42 minus 2, 40.
40.
40i2 is equal to 7 minus
2, 5.
So I2 is equal to 5 by 40. What is that? 1 by?
1 by 8.
1 by 8. So they have taken it as 1 by 8. 1 by 8 is equal to 0.125, I think.
Yes, it's a 0.125.
Okay. So 0.125 ampere. Now, I2 you got. So you can put I2's value in any of this equation. Let me put in this one, equation 2. So I got I1. So equation 2 becomes, equation 2 becomes what? I1 plus 6 times I2. So
0.75.
6 into 0.125 is equal to 1. So if I will get I1 is equal to
0.75. This one.
What? What is it? You can substitute this value, 6 times this and 1 minus that value. So you will get I1's value. If you
teacher,
get
the answer will be 6 into, this one will be 0.75, 6 into 0.125.
Is that clear to you how to solve this?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher, clear.
Okay. So let us again go back and see where we were. So this is how we can use this equation, Kirchhoff's law, in order to solve problems. Okay, can we go and see another problem? This is the one we already discussed, right? So this problem, here they are using voltage law. So an electric circuit is given below. Applying Kirchhoff's law, find the electric current passing through different resistances. So you have to find the current passing through different resistances.
Teacher,
yes.
It's 1:53 right now, and just we have to go for lunch.
Oh, okay, yes. Okay. We will stop it now. I just have to end the meeting, right?
Yes.
Okay. Anyway, you try to see this problem and tell me if there is any doubt. That is numerical example 3.25. If you have doubts, then only we will discuss this in the next class.